Hi there, Rebecca here from Life So Create. If I haven't met you yet, welcome and hello.
Are you looking for a project to advance your clear vinyl sewing skills? If so, this project is super fun because it adds an extra level of dimension, utilizing clear vinyl and pairing it with the charm of cotton fabric. So this is actually a fun way to combine transparency with tradition to create designs that are very unique. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to sew and introduce clear vinyl curves into your project. Imagine the endless potential of creating stunning, one-of-a-kind, eye-catching pieces.
It's actually inspired from the mountains, and I grabbed some footage for you guys. My husband and I and my daughter were actually doing some four-wheeling.
Caught that on video.
Enjoy some of the footage from up here and enjoy this bag make.
Mom, you're gonna get me grunting like an old man. There's still snow.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
waist, I used the bottom of the bag and made this cute little pouch to go inside to hold coins or keys. So here's a happy little accident where I had fused the two panels together. I'm actually going to tear them apart and change of plans, which it actually turned out to be a benefit because the interfacing added a little bit of stability. So it was almost like I had fused it with SF101 on one of the panels and sides. The reason why I did fuse it was because it made it easier to assemble with a zipper and whatnot, and so I'm glad I did it that way. But if you decide to leave it unfused, that would probably work as well. But I did find the benefit that it did not shift while it was fused, and I was able to easily pry the panels apart. Here I am pairing the linings together and clipping them. I just finished boxing the corners, making sure that the seam's going in the same direction. So the inside lining is complete. Okay, so I have the lining on this side, and then
the panels with the extra peekaboo lining all together. And so I'm going to proceed and clip it all together, making sure that the edges match on the two panels here. I want those to match and clip it. We'll check it. And the tail end of that zipper tab, the raw end, will disappear into the seam. This wasn't exactly square, but that's okay. As long as these two line up and these two line up, we're good. As best as you can. I'm gonna take it to the sewing machine and sew. Actually, I'm going to leave the bottom open so I can turn it. Some of the bottom. So, stop right here. Maybe even bigger because it's a little hard to turn. Too close together so that it reminds me to backstitch. Going 3/8 with this as well. Now start a little bit further down and then I'm going to come back and see how close I can get with that. I'm going to trim this part. Same way. 1 inch.
squished it down pretty well. Just go slowly. This is so thick, I'm gonna go through and put another row of stitching. Okay, and then I can just cut off the tip. I'm gonna get the iron and just gently, slightly warm the vinyl up, soften it.